Good evening, students. We are now going to learn a poem from your 11th class Hornbill book, that is, A Photograph by Shirley Tolson. A photograph is a poem where we are going to learn a daughter recalling the memory of her mother, writing a poem in her tribute. This poem is basically describing three stages. It is divided into three parts where the mother of the poet is young and she has gone to a sea holiday where she has spent time with her cousins and she was very happy smiling through the photographs. In the second stage, we will find that the poet was listening to the memories of her mother. They both were sharing that. Looking at the particular photograph, they were sharing the emotion, the feeling, and in the third stage, you will see that the poet is very much sad and recalling the memories when her mother was sharing this incident with her. So, without any delay, we should start the explanation of this poem. But before that, I wanted to inform you that this whole poem has two parts. Today we will be discussing the explanation and in the next part we will be discussing the form, structure, the synopsis, the central idea, the theme and also the poetic devices or the figures of speech which are present in the poem. Okay. Shirley Tolson. She is an English writer, poet, journalist and a local politician. And few of her important books or renowned books are Shadows in an Orchard, Circumcisions, Not Such a Bad Thing After All, The Fault, Dear Brutus, A Zodiac of Sonnets, The Drover's Roads of Wills, East Anglia, Walking the Ley Lines and Ancient Tracks. These are few of the books or renowned books which I have collected. There are many more and she had also, she has a very important role and contributed to the English literature. Okay, so the whole, we should discuss the whole idea behind this poem or the central idea behind this poem is that the poet remembers her mother who died about few years ago and there is a photograph in her home where that photograph is so giving her the memory or making her recalling the memory of her mother when she has visited the mother, when the mother has visited a sea holiday with her cousin and her uncle. Looking at that particular photograph, she experienced the great void in her life that now she is devoid of her that happy memories with her mother and now that her mother is dead, she is not present, she cherished that memories. But we should not forget one main thing which is present in the poem is that it talks about the death in a very clear picture that death will silence everyone and our fate will not be changed and leave you speechless. Okay, now coming to few of the lines of this poem, the cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went peddling, each one holding one of my mother's hand and see the big girl some 12 years or so. In this four lines, you will find that the poet is trying to give a clear picture of a photograph where she finds her mother and her two cousins who has been captured in that particular photograph and it was stuck to a cardboard, okay, in her home. And looking at that photograph, she saw that both the cousins were holding her mother's hand, The mother was present in the middle of the photograph, and she was eldest among them. She was around 12 years or so. She was the big girl among them. Okay. And they were paddling through the beach, the seashore. Okay. They were just, the water were just touching their feet. Okay. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. So all of them, the three of them stood smiling through their hairs. Due to the breeze, due to the wind flowing, so the hairs were also moving around. And through that, they were smiling. They were having a smiling face. They're posing to their uncle, and they were very happy about the sea holiday. Okay. And the mother is also having a sweet face at that time. And this was the time when the poet was not born. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. See, here are two words which is very important to be noticed, that is changeless, which has changed less, the sea, and what is terribly transient, the feet of the mothers, the mother and her cousin. So here it is, so it is giving a great comparison between the sea and the human being. Okay, the nature is unchanged, remain unchanged. The sea is still present there as intact and as it was, but now her mother is not present. Their transient feet is not present. Okay, it was terribly transient, means within a few years she have lost her mother. Okay, and the sea waves are washing the feet of the cousin and her mother. Some 20-30 years later, means after the photograph was taken when she was 12 years old. Okay, the mother of the poet was 12 years old, and now after 20-30 years of that photograph taken, looking at that particular photograph, the mother is sharing with her daughter, the poet, that it is so funny to look at the photograph because the way they are being dressed, they are being overdressed for a sea holiday. Okay, the way they are being dressed, they are so excited. They were being dressed in a very overwhelming way. They are dressed, overdressed for that particular occasion. And she is also saying, look, see, Betty, look, Dolly, how they are being how they are dressed and how they are looking. The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter. So here there is two things again mentioned in this particular stanza, that is the sea holiday was past for her mother and now her laughter is past for me. The mother's laughter is a past for the daughter, the poet. And both vary with the labored age of loss. And both need remembering. Both of them are remembering their past. Both are nostalgic about that. And it is a very difficult loss to cope up with. It is a labored age of loss. See, look at the phrase, the words being used. It is very, very innovative, very interesting and very emotional thing is mentioned here, that the labored years of loss means it is not easy to understand, easy to make us feel better. It is very difficult because it is a very hard time. It is not easy to cope such a big loss. My mother is so much important to me. The memory attached to her is so much important, and her memory of visiting the vacation is also very much important and nostalgic for her. Okay, moving to the last few lines. Now she is being dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. Means the photograph was taken when the mother was 12 years ago. 12 years of old. Now, the her mother is also dead by 12 years ago. Okay, she has lost her mother 12 years ago. So, and of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. Now, she is speechless about losing her mother. It is a very grieving situation. She have no words to utter now. It's silence, silences. Silence is repeated two times. Means the silence here is the death of her mother. The silence is also silence now. It is so difficult time that nobody is able to cope up with this situation. And now everything is confirmed. Nothing can be changed. The fate, the life has already passed away. And I can only remember and be nostalgic. I can recall the memory of the mother. Nothing else I can do. Okay. So, with this line, the poem ends here. And today we will be learning this much. And in our next video, I will discuss the synopsis, the theme, the central idea, the figures of speech, the structure of the poem, and also the form of the poem. So, that's all for today. See you in the next video.